influencing voltage. The influencing voltage is a voltage induced by cables laid next to the track. It will now be explained step by step. In electric traction, the current flows through the overhead line to the traction unit and through the track and partly back to the earth. This creates a magnetic field. Signal and telecommunication cables are laid next to the track. The influence voltage is induced in these cables. This equivalent circuit diagram explains the effects. The upper coil symbolizes the track inductance, the lower ones those of the influenced cables. The level of the influencing voltage depends, for example, on the traction current or the influenced cable length. Deutsche Bahn has defined it as 250 volt. It is permanently present and is therefore called the long-term influencing voltage. In the special case of a short circuit, for example due to a crack in the overhead line, the significantly higher short circuit current also induces a significantly higher voltage. This so-called short-term influencing voltage is defined as a maximum of 1500 volt. Back to the standard case. Here, still without interference. A voltage cycle naturally shows that the source voltage is equal to the on-load voltage. Now, with influencing. The voltage circulation provides an important insight. The influencing voltages of the supply and return lines cancel each other out. The on-load voltage remains unchanged. The influencing voltage is induced in the forward and return lines with the same magnitude and phase relation. The on-load voltage, as a potential difference, therefore does not change. This raises the question of the conditions under which there are effects. Let's start with the effects on people. Touching an affected line alone is not dangerous. A danger to humans only arises with an earth fault. Then the interference voltage is present as touch voltage. To protect against this, the area in which cables can be touched must be earth potential free. Now we come to the effects on devices, for example lightning protection elements, in other words SPD surge protection devices. SPDs must be earthed in order to function properly. This means that the influencing voltage is applied to the SPD in the event of an earth fault. This must be taken into account when designing SPDs. After these basic considerations, here is a practical example. First, without influencing voltage. In normal operation, the interlinked voltage of 400 volt is applied via two arrestors. In the event of an earth fault, the earth potential assumes the L2 potential. There would be 400 volts at the arrestor. However, a 230 volt arrestor is not designed for this load capacity. As a measure, another arrestor, the summation arrestor, is integrated. Now the interference voltage should also be taken into account. It is again induced uniformly in all lines. It is only relevant for the voltage circulation for L2. Here is another important finding. No voltage is induced in the ground, which acts as a return conductor. The influencing voltage is added to the phase-to-phase voltage. The path from the signal and summation arrestor must be designed accordingly. On this basis, the effects for your applications are recognizable. You can then take the necessary measures to ensure safe and reliable operation. These were the basics on the subject of influencing voltage. If you have any questions or suggestions, please get in touch with our contact persons. You can also find more information about our products and solutions on our website. Thank you for your attention.